Yo, what's going on, everybody? It is Straight Outta Boston here, aka the King of Boston. Today we're back for episode 10 of my Jim Lowry Road to the Show series here on MLB 15 The Show. And today we are continuing on with our first major league season here, going up against the Minnesota Twins in our 16th start of the season. And we have taken on the Twins before. We got hit around a little bit the last time we played them in Minnesota. And obviously the last time we were out, we allowed, what, 5 runs, I think it was, in 2 innings against the Oakland A's. So coming off of a bad start here, we're looking to rebound, and we're getting things started off pretty nicely. 2 strikeouts in the first inning on Joe Mauer and Brian Dozier, two of the better hitters in the Twins lineup. So now we're into the top of the second. Yasmeel Pinto leading things off, 0-1 count. That's going to be a ground ball. Hardy dives, makes the stop, throw to first, will be not in time. It's going to be an infield single for Yasmeel Pinto, I believe I'm pronouncing that right. Now Trevor Plouffe up next, first pitch of the AB. He's going to rip one into right field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Now Pinto dove back to second, or to first there, so he's going to have to hurry to get into second, but he does so safely, and it will be a single for Trevor Plouffe. So 2 men on now with no man out for the Minnesota Twins. Eddie Rosario up next, 1-1 count. That's going to be a ground ball. Diving stop by the second baseman, Ray Navarro. Throw to first in time, and that's going to be out number one. But it will advance both runners up a base, so it's going to be second and third with just 1 man out for Kurt Suzuki. The 2-1 count. Suzuki's going to rip one into the gap in left center field. That's going to get down and go all the way to the wall. 2 runs will come home and score, and that is going to make it a 2-0 ball game. Kurt Suzuki gives the Twins the lead. So we're still in the top of the second here. Next batter is going to be Byron Buxton. The 2-1 pitch to the young phenom. That's going to be hitting to deep left field. That ball is back, and goodbye, a 2-run home run. And it's now 4-0 Minnesota. And for the second straight start, Jim Lowry's getting hit around a little bit here. Buxton with a 2-run dinger, and that will extend the Twins' lead. So not a good start here so far for Big Jim. And you can see that fastball just left over the heart of the plate. Buxton absolutely mashes that one. So now top two still. Torrey Hunter up next. He's going to ground this one to the third baseman, to second for one, on to first in time. A 5-4-3 double play, and that will get Lowry out of the inning finally. So we're into the top of the third now. 2-2 count to Pinto. Pinto's going to go down swinging on the curveball. So starting to get some strikeouts at least, which is a good thing, as that's something we sort of struggled with so far in our MLB career. But anyway, you can see the replay there. Pinto not really doing anything on that curveball. Now still top three. Trevor Plouffe up, 1-1 count. That's going to be ripped into right center field, and that's going to get down. The runner on first is going to come around. He will round third and head for home. The cutoff throw, the relay throw, is offline, and then the throw home will be not in time. So it is going to be a 5-0 lead. Now Rosario up next. He's going to ground this one to the first baseman, Chris Davis, who will step on the bag at first and retire the side. But through three here, we've already allowed 5 runs, but then the Twins put up a 7 spot, I believe that was, in the bottom of the fourth or the bottom of the third. I can't even keep track now. So we actually get the lead back, but Lowry's going to walk Brian Dozier there. That's going to put runners on first and second now for Trevor Plouffe. The 1-1 count, and Plouffe hits it to deep center field. This ball is back, and it is gone. A 3-run home run for Trevor Plouffe, and the Twins retake the lead 8-7. And oh my goodness, the Orioles offense gives Jim Lowry the lead back somehow, and he just coughs it right back up, and that would do it. Buck Showalter's going to pull his young starter, and another disappointing start for Jim Lowry. Back-to-back clunkers, 4 2/3, 8 earned runs, that's a new career high, 10 hits, 4 strikeouts, and 1 walk. So Lowry trying to change his luck a little bit here. He's going to take a visit to the barbershop, and he went with the clean shave, the shaved head. Shaved his beard, shaved all of his head, all of the hair on his head, basically. Now some of it's grown back a little bit already, but we're trying to start anew here and turn things around. As really the last, even and it really even extends past the last couple of starts. Lowry has not pitched well lately. ERA's up to 3.67, and things not off to a good start here in the first. But this is going to be lined right at Ref Schneider, and Gerard Dyson was moving on the play. So that is actually going to be an easy double play for Rob Refschneider and the Baltimore Orioles. A little bit of luck right there. Eric Osmer up next. And Osmer to deep left center field. This ball is back. And once again, we allow a home run. The home run problems continue. And oh my goodness, it doesn't even seem that the clean shaven head can save Jim Lowry at this point. So you can see Osmer celebrating in the dugouts with his Royals teammates. But now bottom of the first, Mike Moustakas up with a man on first. That's going to be ripped. Diving stop by, that's not even Manny Machado, who got the day off today. I believe that's Ray Navarro, playing third base. So we're into the bottom of the second now. Man on first. Christian Colon up. Colon's going to ground this one. They go to second for one on to first and a big 5-4-3 double play. Nicely turned by the Orioles infield defense. Another good play by Ray Navarro over at third. Now we're into the bottom of the third. Man on first. One man on. That's going to be ripped into right field. Diving catch by Nolan Reimold, who gets up, and he would actually be injured on the play, amazingly enough. Nolan Reimold injures himself, actually breaks a bone in his hand. So if you get injured making a diving catch for me, I think I owe you a steak dinner. But anyway, that's going to be a base hit into right field. Gerard Dyson rounding third. He's headed home. One of the fastest men in MLB gets gunned out by the new right fielder, Jimmy Paredes. The defense helping out Lowry again. But take a look at this. Through three innings, we've allowed seven hits. It's honestly incredible that we haven't allowed more than one earned run so far. Now, this isn't even actually a three-pitch strikeout. This was just a nice little sequence I liked there. Two breaking balls, and then we go with the fastball on 0-2. Induces the ground out from Moustakas. Now we're into the bottom of the fourth. Two more men on. This is going to be Drew Butera, and finally we get our first strikeout of the evening here. And we get that K counter on the board. Now bottom five, Gerard Dyson up 0-2 count. And Dyson is going to take that changeup. He will go down looking strikeout number two for Lowry. As he started to settle down, like I said, he allowed, I think, nine hits through four innings. But after that, really settled into his own here. Finally started looking like the Jim Lowry of old. And it appears maybe that new haircut's finally doing some work. As you can see, Moustakas looking silly on that outside changeup. And now we're into the bottom of the sixth. Alex Gordon up 2-2 count. And Gordon's going to go down looking on that high fastball. Didn't like the call there from the home plate umpire. But Lowry will certainly take it. Now into the bottom of the 7-2-2 count. That's going to be strike three to Moises Sierra on the fastball up and in. So five strikeouts for Lowry. And, you know, after that one at bat inning in the first, he really started to settle down and looked pretty good throughout the rest of the game. Especially after the first couple of innings. I mean, really innings 5 through 7, I would say, were really starting to look like a Jim Lowry of old. But anyway, Gerard Dyson with a little bloop double down the left field line. That would do it for him. Showalter would pull him from the game. Now, luckily, the bullpen would be able to strand Dyson out there. I think he actually got thrown out stealing third. But as you can see, after we got through those first four innings, only one hit allowed in the final three. And we actually turned out a pretty good start here. I mean, you know, definitely, like I said, a lot of hits in the beginning of the game. But some of that was just bad BABIP luck. And five strikeouts through seven innings, we'll certainly take that. So pretty good start overall. Now we are going to Texas to take on Chichi Gonzalez and the Texas Rangers. Chichi Gonzalez, another top pitching prospect. So a battle of young arms here, young right-handed arms. And as you can see, some of the stats here. Both guys entered the loss with 7 losses and a .277 opponent's batting average. So anyway, we're getting things started here in the first with a nice 5-4-3 double play. Doubling up Elvis Andrus is not something very easy to do, but again, this Orioles infield defense really helping out. Now man on second with no one out. That's going to be a backdoor curveball that will strike out Mitch Moreland looking. Strikeout number one on the evening for Lowry. We get that K counter back up on the board. Now Delano DeShields up two batters later. He's going to go down swinging on that slider. We haven't had a strikeout on a slider in a while, but we finally get one there. And now we get ahead of Adrian Beltre, 0-2 here. In the bottom of the fourth with one man out. And Beltre takes that high fastball to deep left field. That is back. And that is a no-doubt solo home run. And Beltre puts the Rangers on the board there, giving them the first run, or their first run of the game. I do not quite remember what the score was, but anyway, Adrian Beltre with a solo shot, one of the best third basemen to play the game of baseball in recent times. But anyway, bottom five, now it's a 3-1 game. DeShields laying down a bunt. That's going to go foul for strike one. Another bunt, a failed attempt for strike two, and then we get him on the inside changeup. I tried to put that one in the outer half of the play. I actually missed with my location, but it works out. And that is our first three-pitch strikeout in a couple of episodes here. So things really looking like they're starting to turn around here for Lowry. And that's a throw down to second. That is going to be in time. We throw out Adam Rosales, the base runner, so really, our defense has been so helpful to us throughout this entire rookie season. We end up hitting Leonis Martin here. He's going to get on base. But luckily for us, the man who would be up next is going to be Elvis Andrus. Elvis Andrus already has grounded into one double play today. Now 1-0 count. That's going to be a ground ball. And that is a tailor-made double play ball to second for one on the first in time. It's a 4-6-3 DP. And we turn that one to now get us into the bottom of the sixth. Beltre up once again, still a 3-1 ball game. And Beltre, does he have another one? And he does! It's going to be a solo shot for Adrian Beltre. That will cut the lead to 3-2 now. As Beltre, really the only Texas Ranger to get anything going off of Jim Lowry so far. We're into the bottom of the seventh. Still, the Orioles have the lead. That's going to be ripped into right center field. That will get down, and Adam Jones will cut that one up before it gets to the wall. But Chu is on his way to second, and he will get in there safely. So Shin-Soo Chu getting things going here for the Texas Rangers in the bottom of the seventh inning. And that would do it for Jim Lowry. Buck Showalter would come out and take out his young starter. The run would not come home and score, so Lowry's day would be done. Six innings pitched, eight hits, two earned runs, three strikeouts, one walk. Not great stuff from Lowry today, but still a pretty good start, especially when you think about what we've done lately. And, you know, definitely think we're on the right track as we enter the stretch run here. 65-63, still a slight chance. Maybe we can make a quick little run here at the end and try and get into the playoffs, but if not, we'll certainly look at some personal goals, really just, you know, steadying our ERA a little bit and, you know, just having a good final month of the season, I think, is really what we want to do here. So, all right, that is going to do it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you did enjoy, and I'm out. Peace.